Hi, Irene here. So in this video, we're going to see how to use the Dynamo player from Dynamo within Revit to play scripts created by others, whether those are individuals or companies. So let's get right to it. Okay, so here you can see that I have three elements. I have an object, I have a path, and I have a surface. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to be using scripts generated by third parties to kind of like place this object along either the path or on this surface. Now, the scripts that I'm going to be using today belong to a company called Arquitree. They basically offer intelligent parametric families with variable levels of detail, but they also have scripts that you can implement. So it's kind of like a two-part deal. You have to work with their families in order to use their scripts, but they have pretty cool stuff. They have a free section, so you know, you can definitely explore them. So this little tree that I have here is from them. In order to be able to use these scripts, the first thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna want to download and install said scripts, said packages. So to do that, we're gonna go on Dynamo and we're gonna go packages, search for packages, and we're gonna type Arquitree. There she is. So you're gonna download it. Now, what I would recommend at this point is you can actually find the location. So I can click here, install version to folder, because basically what I want is I want to know the location of these folders, because you're gonna have to kind of like load them on the Dynamo player. So I know here that it's Siri, AppData, Roman, Dynamo, Dynamo Revit 2.3 packages, right? So we can now close this. And when I click my Dynamo player, if you've just downloaded it, you're not going to see anything here. You have to load them. So to do that, you would click, and this is where knowing the address of the package would come in handy. So see, it's on Siri, AppData, Roaming, Dynamo, Dynamo Revit 2.1, packages, Arquitree populate, and we're going to go with the extra. So, okay. And now here are the different options that come within that package. So you have three types of families in a boundary by percentage, or three types on face or in boundary, four types, any types. So a bunch of different options here. So let's see how they work. First thing, I'm gonna try this any types on path at equal distance. So I'm gonna play the script. And it's going to tell me I have to do a certain number of selections for the script to work. Remember, when we're talking about Dynamo, the script is just a set of instructions. You're still going to have to provide an input in order to get an output. So I am going to select here my families. So click there, and you can select by drag and release. There you go. It has recognized it. Select the path. To select my path, there she is. Now you can choose the distance between the elements. Let's reduce it there. Minimum height, maximum height, I'm gonna leave that. And create planters, false, we don't wanna create planters, and we're gonna say yes. And as you can see, this is taking some time, so we're just gonna be patient. I'm gonna pause here and I'm gonna come back when it's done doing it. Oh Lord Jesus. Yikes. Okay, so you can see there's a lot of geometries, because basically my spacing, I'm on Imperial, so it's basically putting them every 3.5 inches. So remember, when you're working with Dynamo, Dynamo scripts will pick up whatever unit system you're working on. So I'm gonna have to increase this dramatically. Let's say every like 50. And what I'm gonna do is, oh gosh. Now you want to be careful here, because the geometry has already been generated. So just rerunning it, it's not going to replace it. It's just going to add. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna go undo. Ooh. And we're gonna do this again. The objects are already selected, but I'm gonna put my distance between objects to 50. Oh, 20 seems to be the maximum. See, this is where it might be convenient to change the unit system that you're working on. So let's leave it to 20 and see what happens. It should be a little bit faster. And there you go. Would you look at that? Isn't that cool? So you just need an object and a path. Now let's try another one. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to now do a surface one. So let's say that we want to put this tree on these floor platform that I created. So in this case, we're going to be using the any types on face. So I'm going to click here, any type on face, and same thing. It's going to ask me to select the family. So I'm going to select my tree, and then it's going to ask me to select the face. Now be careful with this one. Remember, like, your geometries have multiple faces. So I'm going to make sure that I'm choosing the top face here. Minimum distance between elements. Again, I'm going to crank that up to 50. Maximum number of elements. I definitely do not want it to be 50. Let's say 20. So again, I play with all my variables and then I play the script. See? So this is really, really handy. This is when you can start seeing how Dynamo can be a fantastic tool to automate and speed up a lot of processes that usually take a long time. The other thing that I really like about this is that once you've downloaded a script, you can actually click on this little pen here, edit in Dynamo, and it's basically going to, you know, pull behind the curtain so you can see how these scripts are generated. Now, you cannot modify these scripts because, you know, they're like intellectual property of Arquitree, but you can see how they're built and you could build your own iteration of them. So see, here it's telling me I have two selection boxes and then I have the number of elements. See? So you can see here kind of like how things are built up, and then we have the element output. So you can use this as kind of like a starting point to create your own script. Maybe you want to make one where you don't have to necessarily only work with Arquitree families. You want to work with your own families. Or maybe you want to be able to choose, instead of like randomizing on surface, maybe you want to do that attractor point that you can see on another video that I did. So once you start digging on what you can do with Dynamo, really the world is your burrito, as they say. So I hope you liked this video, and if you did or you have any questions, you can, you know, always leave a comment. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in another video. Bye.